Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Dynasty in NCAA 13. We are in year 4, and this is week 2. We're coming off a tough loss to the number 19 team in the nation, and it doesn't get any better because we got the number 24 team in the nation, the Pitt Panthers, coming in this week. But let's do some recruiting before we get there, looking at some players here that we want to fully scout out. Robert Vincent being one of them, because he could very possibly, with these numbers, become the heir apparent here to the running back position from Jim Mitchell when he graduates after this year. So looking at Lance Fletcher, the defensive end as well. Just trying to scout out these guys as much as we can with the time we have for scouting on the week. Looking at Antoine Williams as well. Now, are we going to get all these high-rated guys? No, we're not going to get all of them. Are we going to get some of them? Hopefully. But, you know, we got to make the shot at making this roster better. And so while I go through this, it's pretty self-explanatory. You can see the points that I'm getting. I don't have to explain what the thinking is here on each of these, just that we're making progress with each of these recruits. But I have a question I'm going to pose right off the bat while we're doing recruiting here. I have been showing recruiting just about every episode, but it gets a little tedious because not a lot happens from week to week other than guys deciding to sign on their scholarships. Now, that's big news, obviously, and that'll always be covered. But my question to you is, do you want to see recruiting every week? Do you want to see recruiting become maybe a quarterly thing, maybe four times a year, you know, roughly, just checking in on the progress? Because going from one week to the next, a lot of times you won't see a lot of movement on these guys unless you make a major move on somebody's board or discover somebody that you had not singled out at all before. Like, those are major moves, but I'm thinking that recruiting could almost be covered in a quarterly fashion. But I want to know your feedback, so go down to the comments section. Let me know what you think about recruiting. Do you want to see it every episode, or do you want to see it just every so often in updates on what we're doing? Because I think that would actually cover things if that is what you guys choose. So with that being said, it's time to play another ranked opponent. Welcome to the Big East, right? Yeah. Well, it's a pretty big initiation, and Pitt plans to come in and do just more of that today. So Jim Mitchell stretching here, getting ready. Got to get the afterburners in place here. He's a speedster when he gets out in the open field, and he's hoping to do just that today. So UMass gets ready to take the field. Four straight home games to start the year. They've already lost the first, as it was a tough battle with Louisville, but they made too many mistakes. They didn't get it done. So they're hoping that this week of practice cleaned things up. They'll have a lot fewer turnovers, and that they can stay with Pitt for most of this game, if not give them a run for their money. So Pitt right off the bat gets the ball first and gets a nice run right there. So first and 10, and Anderson's going to throw, and that play does not work. UMass all over that. Nice reactions by a linebacker there to take that one down. Third and 3, they will convert, however. Davis with the high hurdle and gets a first down yardage. So on first and 10 out of the shotgun, Anderson is going to load to throw, but he underthrows, and Reed picks him off. Interception, UMass going the other way. Great defensive play, and we've got the ball back. Makes the decision to defer and kick look even that much better now that they've turned over the Pitt Panthers on offense. So here we go with UMass bringing out their offense. Get Jim Mitchell settled in this ball game. You know that's a high priority, so let's get right to that. Running to the outside of the right. Spin move. Oh, no, they didn't fall for that, but he does get 5 yards in the process. Second and 5, and we send Stokes, the tight end, in motion. Going to change this play to the left-hand side. Mitchell's going to get first down yardage before getting blasted to the turf. Okay, so here we go. And they read this outside run. Maybe one too many times to the well here as Meadows hands off to Mitchell. And as they do, he's met immediately in the backfield. Second and 14 now. Meadows to throw. Oh, this is kind of tricky because Houston is covered, but he gets up to make the catch. Ronnie Houston makes a great catch in traffic, and Meadows trusted him to do just that. Look at this throw, and even better than the throw, look at Houston go up and make this catch in front of the defender and hang on to it. That's the most important part. And UMass is set just outside the 10-yard line. So Meadows drops back and finds Stokes coming across the field. And on the 3rd-and-2 play, a new wrinkle. We're running option. Meadows. Oh, my goodness. He hurdles for no real reason. And he probably should have gotten in there, but they will get 1st and goal nonetheless. Another option look. This one in the pistol form. They hand off to Mitchell, and he barrels in for the touchdown. Pitt did not see this on film at all, I guarantee you, because we have not run option, well, once in the 3 years that I can think of. So it was suggested that maybe we look into that because Meadows does have really good speed at the quarterback position. So they tricked him on 3rd-and-2, really didn't see it coming. Nice play by Powell there, the solid middle linebacker. Makes a stop for a loss, 2nd-and-12. Davis is going to shoot right through there like a pinball and get it down to 3rd-and-2. Very much more manageable there. Powell was coming with heat on the right side. They go to the other side and get the first down. 1st-and-10, Davis, another first down run. Pitt starting to click on offense for themselves. Here comes a blitz, but they're going to meet it with a short pass over the middle that negates that. So 2nd-and-1, play action. All kinds of time for Anderson to throw. Wide open receiver down the field. I believe that's Dahl, the tight end. And he makes a catch, and it is 1st-and-goal. Now 2nd-and-goal for Pitt. Davis, after contact, will bounce outside. Too late for Randy Smith getting there to take him down. He's already in the end zone. Pitt ties the ball game with a rushing touchdown, and we have got a good game in our hands in the first half. As you see Davis getting congratulations at the bench, it's Mitchell's turn, and he's going to cut inside and then back out. First down, nice run of about 12 or 13 yards right there. 3rd-and-10 now, and we got the Minutemen microscope checking out why. Wide open downfield, but Meadows doesn't see it. He checks down and almost throws an interception. That blown read is key because now UMass must punt the football. So still a 7-7 ball game, 2.5 minutes before half. Davis is met in the hole there, not going anywhere. It's going to be 3rd-and-3. What do they have on 3rd down? Anderson, the short drop, finds his man for 1st down and more inside the 40 of UMass. So they've got a 1st down and trying to get points before the half. 2 minutes remaining now. Anderson gets hit from behind, does get rid of the football before taking the sack, but he does get hit, as does Davis on this play. It'll be 3rd and 9 now. What are they going to do out of the shotgun? Will they be conservative? Well, yeah, they hand off to Davis and get down to the 30, maybe to the 29. Timeout, UMass. And it'll be 4th and 3. They'll try a field goal of 46 yards. It is going to be just wide right. Field goal is no good, and UMass is held. So with 1:29 remaining, Meadows goes underneath the Ronnie Parker. First time we've heard from Ronnie today. And he makes the 1st down catch and maneuver after the catch. So Meadows is going to go deep now, trying to get to Ronnie Houston. Almost caught and then almost picked off. So they'll have to try again. 2nd and 10 now. Trying to get him to jump offside is Meadows. He's looking to throw. Will throw to Mitchell. He maneuvers past his man. It looked like they weren't going to get much there, but Mitchell's speed helps him turn up the sideline on this play instead of getting hit. And he's just a yard short of the 1st down. Not even. So 3rd and inches. He gets the call on the ground and gets a 1st down. So here we are now, 2nd and 9, 30 seconds left. Meadows is going to throw deep, and it's Ronnie Houston. Lays out and makes the catch. 2nd and goal, going back to that option formation. And Meadows will keep this time and get in the end zone for the touchdown. So once again, they go option on the goal line, and once again, they get in. So we've seen a new theme here, a new wrinkle from the UMass offense. Loving to see this with a fast quarterback. You can see just how quick his acceleration is there, and they had no chance of stopping that play. So UMass gets in, and it's 14-7. Only 15 seconds left before half, but Anderson wants to get something done. All he's going to accomplish is get sacked by Randy Smith. He gets another one here. As you see the nice move here, they just cannot contain him, and he finally gets to the quarterback who took too long to try to get this ball away. So that will expire the clock in the first half. Your halftime score is UMass 14 and the number 24 Pittsburgh Panthers 7. Well, we deferred that ball to the second half, meaning we get it to start the second half right here. And we're starting with Jim Mitchell to the left. Now we have a lineman jumping on the O-line, which is not going to be good because it's going to set us back 5 yards that we just gained, putting us at 2nd and 10. We've got the screen play on. Let's see if they bite. They're coming full force. Oh, just a second too soon getting the ball out to Mitchell. Otherwise, that would have been a big play. Bad missed opportunity because right here, Carrington picks this ball off. Going for Ronnie Parker. If he gets some air under this and gets it downfield, I think Parker catches it and maybe scores. Instead, Meadows left it hanging a little bit, and it was picked off by Carrington. So here come the Panthers the other way with a short field. Anderson is going to throw, and he throws for a first down right there on 1st and 10, just inside the 20. Goes over the middle and a big catch. Wow, big hit as well. 2nd and 1, Davis is going to run down inside the 5. It'll be 1st and goal. He's got 54 yards rushing. And he's got another touchdown on this pitch. Pitt is in for their 2nd score, tying the game at 14, as it'll be Davis once again. You see the nice block on the outside springs him for the easy touchdown. So there you go, knotted at 14. What does UMass's offense have? Well, they want to go option not just at the goal line, but here. But Meadows, oh my goodness, that pitch, while he gets hit, and the ball squirts loose. Mitchell falls on it, luckily, but they're down to their own, like, 6-yard line, and they got to be careful. Meadows is going to go to Mitchell, just kind of the safety valve right there, the underneath. It's still 3rd and 14. He's trying to make something happen here. Nice touch on this pass to Young, but he cannot hang on. Now, granted, it might have been a little bit of a tough catch, but you got to catch those in that situation. They got to punt. So here comes Davis on the draw. Look at him shifting around and getting down to about the 30-yard line. This play does not work. This is going backwards, and what a hit right there. That's Bowen Nelson. He's brand new to the squad this year, highly rated JUCO transfer, and he's doing well right there. Another play for a loss. This is a big play with linebackers coming right up the middle and making a stop. So a punt for Pitt, and it's back to Jim Mitchell, as he's going to get a first down right there for UMass on 1st and 10 as the 3rd quarter is almost out. Mitchell explodes through the hole up the middle for 7 yards. It'll be 2nd and 3. Looking to give him the ball again with Coleman, the fullback, out in front of him. He gets just enough for another first down. We are into 4th quarter play. Let's drive and get a winning score, shall we? Or go-ahead score. Pass to Joe Stokes on the play action. Works for 8 yards. 2nd and 2. Hand off to Mitchell. Another first down. I like the momentum we have crossing midfield. 4 minutes left. Mitchell outside. Starting to wear these guys down a little bit. There's some room out there. He gets 7, but oh no, Mitchell is injured again. How many times have we said that in this series? 3rd and 2, and his replacement in. Let's run option. We got the microscope on him again. Meadows makes an incorrect read here. He should have kept the football, but he pitched to Jones. He gets hit. He fumbles. Luckily, they fall on it, but the quarterback keeper on the option would have been the smart play here, as they were reading running back all the way. Wow, big hit and causes a fumble. They got a punt, so that's not good. We're still tied at 14. Anderson's going to use the legs this time. Powell meets him, and Pyle drives him down to the ground. But it is a first down, and Anderson isn't done. He's looking to throw now. Out to Miles is going to make a catch. They get 6 yards there. Getting close to 2 minutes remaining. As a matter of fact, it'll be right about 2 minutes when this ball is snapped. 2nd and 4. Anderson just gets away from Smith. Oh, how frustrating. He almost had him. Slides down. Proves to be evasive right there. Oh, man. So 1st and 10. It is a handoff to Davis. Out of the shotgun draw. 4 yards. But Davis is injured. Now, they are out attending to him, which means he should be out of the ball game. Pitt pulls one over on everyone here. Who's still lined up in the backfield there? It's Davis. Wow, that's convenient, because Anderson throws to him for a first down. What's going on, refs? Get him off the field. That was the very next play. That should not be allowed, but yet they got a first down out of it. Anderson is going to load up and throw. He finds Brown, who is in the end zone. Oh, they burnt the UMass defense there to get the go-ahead score. And for the first time today, Pitt leads the ball game 21-14, as you see the big play once again, and Pitt is more than excited. to get in the end zone and take the lead. So only a minute left, a minute and change. Meadows loading up, double coverage, but Ronnie Parker doesn't care. Makes the catch at midfield. My goodness, what a catch. Third and 10 now. Meadows is flushed out of the pocket to the right. He throws behind his receiver, who I don't even think was looking for the ball, and it's picked off. Yeah, it would have helped to let him there, but I don't think Dobbs even saw the pass coming his way. It's an unfortunate interception and turnover, and now you got to make a stop and use those timeouts. First down stop, first timeout. Second and 8, Shell bounces through there. They do stop him short of the first down, so another timeout taken. Here's the big play, 3rd and 3. Great play on the left-hand side to make him lose a yard. Final timeout. They will at least get the ball back. Here comes the punt, and they're going to try to coffin corner them here. That's a good kick. No return allowed, and here we go for Meadows. Over the middle to Joe Stokes, the tight end, makes the catch. Hurry up offense, no timeouts left. Meadows on 1st and 10. Gonna throw over the middle. Knocked down, could have been intercepted, but they'll get another shot because he could not catch it. Now Meadows, deep to Joe Stokes, makes the catch, the tight end is off and running. He's gone! The tying score with just seconds left. Yes, I know this game is glitched a bit on the home run balls in these situations, but you know what? I'm not going to apologize for it. We take what we need to get back in this game. Joe Stokes runs a route that they cannot defend, and he's in the end zone for the touchdown. Meadows is psyched because they got the ball game tied with just seconds to go in regulation. Joe Stokes, the freshman, getting lots of love there on the sideline after his long scoring play. So with 10 seconds left, let's just make sure that Pitt doesn't get down the field and in field goal position. Patton makes a catch. We'll give him that underneath stuff. And there'll be 4 seconds left for one more play. Anderson is going to heave it up there, maybe hope for a miracle. In a big scrum of players, it is picked off. McBride makes the interception for UMass, and we are going to overtime. Well, one thing's for certain, we've played number 24, Pitt, very tough in this game. Win or lose, UMass should be proud of stepping up into Big East play here and holding their own against a ranked opponent. But we want to get this win, so let's go get it, huh? In overtime, we win the toss, and we'll go on defense first so we know exactly what we need. So let's see the first down play here from Anderson. Handing off to Shell. No, they were all over that. Linebacker right up in the gap to take him down. 2-yard loss. 2nd and 12. What do we dial up on defense now? Anderson, quick drop and throws this ball away. It looks like he had a man at the sideline, but that's an errant pass. 3rd and 12. They really need something positive here as they don't want to kick a field goal. They want 7 points, but here they're short. It's 4th and 4. They will have to settle for a field goal attempt. It is up. And it is no good. It hits the upright. No good. This means UMass can win with a field goal on their possession. Oh, Pitt can't believe it. They missed the kick. So we hand off to Jones. Yes, Jim Mitchell not coming back in this ball game. Jones gets a solid carry of about 8 yards. And they're not going to waste any time. They want to bring the kicking unit on just in case something happens here. And this could win the ball game. Patton. The spot, the hold, the kick. It is good, and UMass wins in overtime. They beat a ranked opponent, and they get their first Big East victory right here against the Pittsburgh Panthers. The kick sails through for Patton, and it's a 24-21 victory in overtime for the Minutemen. Oh, their fans can't believe it, but they did it. So they knocked down a ranked opponent here in Big East play, their first Big East victory. What a milestone win. What a signature win for Junk Johnson and his squad. This ought to sit well with recruits, I would certainly hope. Joe Stokes, your player of the game, made the touchdown catch to draw us even and get us to overtime and have the opportunity for the upset. It has happened. UMass wins, and it's my number one ranked instant classic game of all time in NCAA 13. Yeah, very good game. It deserved that. Joel Meadows, 255 yards, 2 interceptions, but he does have the touchdown. And he scored on the ground as well. So Jim Mitchell, not a lot of yardage. They're keying on him. You know, these are tough defenses, but he does get 59 yards before getting knocked out of the ball game. And your receiving leaders, Joe Stokes leads the way. Ronnie Houston, two big catches for 84 yards. And you see everyone else falling in line there. So a big victory for UMass to pull the 1-1 in the season and get that win against a ranked opponent and the very first Big East win in the school's history. So, wow, we catch our breath now and we fast forward a week. The next game in, remember, four straight home games before we have four straight road games. And they're all conference games. So we get Cincinnati next. Looking forward to that one. More UMass football next time around. We'll see you then.